Hey, it's your bro. I hope you're doing well. And in this video, we're going to be discussing the span and div tags in HTML. Let's get into it. I promise that this will not be a long video. It's going to be super quick. So the span and div tags define a section or division on an HTML page. Typically, we use a pair of these tags as a container for HTML elements so that we can style something specific with CSS or perform some sort of procedure using JavaScript with anything marked with these tags. So I'm going to create some sample text. I'll create a header for our span tag, and I'll just call this span for a title. So span tag, let's close this, and let's do the same thing for our div tag. So let's use an h1 header, doesn't really matter. And we'll type in div tag and close this. Let's also create some sample text. If you're using Sublime Text, you can just type in lorem and hit tab. Let's surround this with a pair of paragraph tags. And then we're just simply going to copy and paste this for the div tag example. So then I can show you the similarities and differences of each of these tags then. So let's save this, reload the page, and this will work for our demonstration. Let's begin by discussing span tags. We can target an element or portion of our web page that we want to style. It depends on where we place our span tags within our text or our HTML document. Let's say that we want to change the color of a single sentence within our paragraph. Well, we can just add a span tag around whatever we want to target and add some attributes or changes within the opening span tag. So let's say that we want to change this sentence right here. Let's just add an opening span tag and a closing span tag where we want these changes to end. All right, so let's save this, refresh the page. No apparent changes, right? Well, let's add the style attribute to the opening span tag, and let's just say that the color is going to be red. We want the color to be red. So let's save this, reload now, and now just this specific sentence is red. It depends on where you place the span tags. If we were to move the closing span tag to, let's say, I don't know, right here, I'm just placing it somewhere random. Well, everything between these two span tags is going to be changed with whatever attributes you placed within the opening span tag. But you want to make sure that you have a closing span tag, because if you forget to close it, it's going to change everything after the opening span tag. Now I'm going to place that closing span tag where this was previously and just reload the page. Now the div tag is almost identical to the span tag. However, anything within a pair of div tags is considered a block level element, so it will begin on a new line and take up the full width available on your web page. Let's place a pair of div tags in the same place that we had previously in the other example. So we'll have an opening div tag there and here as well. And we're going to take our style that we had in the previous example and place it within our div tag. Let's save, reload the page. Now, the main difference between a div tag and a span tag is that with this div tag, you can see that when we reach the div tag, it begins on a new line, and anything within the div tag takes up the entire width of your web browser, and anything after that will also begin on a new line. So that's the main difference between a span tag and a div tag. So that's your super quick lesson on the difference between span tags and div tags, and I'll post all the code that we have in the comments down below. And in the next lesson, we're going to be moving on to CSS. Hey you, if you enjoyed this lesson, then you can help me help you in 3 easy steps by smashing that like button, drop a comment down below, and subscribe if you'd like to become a fellow bro.